It was kind of a struggle at first to make the two mesh. Because when I think revival, I think the day of Pentecost. You know, I think things being turned upside down and impacting the world. But the more I pondered the thought, I found revival to take place first individually.
Amen.
Before it ever spreads abroad, it takes place here. So I began to think about some of the women of the Bible, and the more I thought, the more unfavorable it became, because I thought about Eve, and I was pretty sure that Adam didn't think after a certain incident they had a lot of peace. And so then I thought about Sarah, and we all know that between Sarah and Abraham, they are still fighting the war that she started with Hagar. And I thought, okay, well, that's not a good example of peace. And then I went to the kingdom of Ahaz. He was the king at that time, but he had this wife, Jezebel. And we don't need to talk about that one. And then there was Jacob and Rachel and Isaac and Rebekah and Samson and Delilah. There was one instance of non-peace. Or unpeace, if that is a word, after another, that women contributed a great deal to. But God began to show me how, even through the things that happened with these women and within these families, his hand never stopped ruling.
Amen. Amen.
And because of several incidents that happened during this time, we either have life lessons that we can learn, or the world was impacted, and actually in a positive way, by some of the things that happened there. But the passage of scripture that God laid on both of our hearts, and it was kind of weird because we were trying to decide what we're going to talk about, and so I came up with my scriptures, and then he preached to me a little while his scriptures and his thoughts, and the scriptures were right back to back. I had the first half of the passage, and he had the second half of the passage. So whatever God wants for you tonight will come from Titus. Who was a harlot, but God saw fit to have her being considered an older woman. But I want to encourage you today that it doesn't matter how old you are. If you're 25, there's a 15-year-old looking at you.
Amen.
If you're 15, there's a 5-year-old looking at you.
Amen.
And you have the opportunity to leave a legacy and to instill in them the characteristics of a peaceful woman. Don't take the power that you have in your hands and allow the enemy to use our nature, because see, our nature is sort of manipulative. Well, no, not sort of. I got to a point in my marriage when I had to ask myself, are these real tears or am I just trying to get what I want? Sometimes you would do well to ask yourself that question. But there's another side to us too. When God created the heavens and the earth, and then when he got down to man, he kept saying, you know, this is good, I did this, this is good. And then he got down to man and he said, you know, there's not a helpmate for him. This is not good. And the crown of creation, everything had been created. Everything except for us. And it's the first time that God said, this is not good. We have a great task and a great responsibility. In the book of 2 Timothy 1:5, we find the scripture, therefore, I remind you to keep ablaze the gift of God. That is not the right scripture. Okay, I will just tell it to you. And then you can probably tell me where it is. But it's the passage that reminds Titus to, or Timothy, to stir up the gift, or the calling that is in him, the faith that is in him, that was put in him by his grandmother and by his mother. What type of legacy are you leaving? Will those that come behind you and those that knew you be able to say, this child has the same faith that his or her mother had, or his or her sister had, or his or her aunt had, because you impacted someone's life with the gospel of peace and a message of faith. We have a great responsibility. One example of this is found in Proverbs 31. We usually start at verse 10, and it says, who can find a virtuous woman? And we know that, and we go all the way through that, but let's back up verses 1 through 9. Because it says, these are the words of King Lemuel's mother to her son. She was giving him advice on what type of woman to find. As a woman of God, are you impacting the men and the women in your life with who you are? Are you spreading the gospel of peace in your life? Are you grabbing hold of the faith that's in you so that it can be reproduced? And please, don't leave here tonight and forget what you've heard. God has a message for you. He's trying to tell you something. What kind of legacy are you leaving when it comes to the gospel of peace? You can leave here and say, I heard it, and then you can go home and be the same nagger that you've always been. If you're single, you can go home and be the same witch that you've always been.
Oh,
wow. To the people at the grocery store or at the cleaners, always seeking your way, having attitude, being a murmurer and a complainer, being a contentious person. You can leave here and be that. Or are you going to take the word of God tonight and become a woman of peace? That's the calling on our lives. Change is never easy, but it's necessary. And we benefit from changing. God bless you. Grow with Dr. Barry Rogers.